Surprise, our y1 is 2x minus 1 and y2 is x squared. Without further ado, we graph. Okay, now let's say we want to see another zoom screen, so we select zoom and option 4 for ZDecimal. For the x-axis it goes from negative 4.7 to 4.7 and the y is negative 3.1 to 3.1. It's pretty cool as a default zoom in. However, what's really cool about this is if you need to trace, the trace increment is 0.1. It's really nice if you have to see the intricacies of some functions. Now, I'm going to zoom, go back to standard, and now I want to see, let's say, an undistorted view of the graph. Because if you notice the default of this, it looks like the x-axis is stretched out a bit because this viewing screen is wider than it is taller, much like, say, a high-def TV. So let's go to zoom and select option 5 for z-square. This is an attempt to undistort the graph. This is important, especially if you're doing work with conic functions or conic sections. Because if you have to see what a circle really looks like, you want to go to this function, the zoom 5 z square, because otherwise circles are going to appear as ellipses on the default settings of this calculator.